Welcome again, and today we're going to try and put all that we've been learning, the different sort of breathing techniques together as a daily session. And so we'll begin as we always do with the three-part breathing into the tummy, into the sides of the rib cage, and up towards the shoulder blades. Again, you know, this is something you can do in bed and great way to start the day. And if you don't do anything else, I really recommend this breathing to improve your quality of life, and certainly any meditation you may be doing, it will just help an awful lot. So just bring your mind down into the place you're sitting, just settle and rest your focus on the tips of your nostrils, and just gauge and focus on the breath, gently going in and out. And then when you're ready, just breathing out first, gently breathing out expiration, and then as you breathe in, start to breathe into the tummy, ballooning back and front, into the rib cage, side and back, and up towards the shoulder blades, without moving the shoulders, no strain, and controlling the breath, breathing out. So you just do a few of those, and as you follow the breath, really feel like you're just moving into an empty space, just filling a lovely empty space. A lovely balloon that you're just opening out. No strain. Remembering to fill the back as well as the front. And just do a couple of minutes of this. About underneath the armpits, going there, right into the shoulder blades, opening out, softening. So it's not a big deep breath, and there's no strain with it. It's just a way of controlling the breath, and actually learning to breathe as we should do, using the tummy, opening out the rib cage, and really just filling up into the tops of the lungs without strain. And when you're doing it in bed, maybe practicing this, you can try putting your hands behind your head as well. And this is quite interesting, because you really fill up into the shoulder blades without any strain, and under the armpits. And also, it's important to at first, you know, turn over onto your tummy when you're practicing this breath, so you can really, really start to feel at the back of the body and really open that out. So just a couple more breaths like this, and really following the breath into that lovely, lovely empty space. Feel all the edges softening. And then relax the breathing. All those points to remember, and with practice it just becomes natural. A lovely way to breathe, great way to keep your health. Breath is life, so the better we breathe, the better quality of life we have. And then we continue next with the rhythmic breathing. So having taken a rest, make sure we don't strain the lungs, and we're going to extend the exhalation a little bit this time. And with this breath, because breath and prana that we're breathing in connects us through the winds. It connects us to the subtle body. This is part of the work of pranayama, you know, so it's not just doing breathing exercises, although they are great alone, but it gives us a chance to actually, by travelling with the breath, we start to get in touch with the winds and the softer, subtle body. Okay, so enough of that, but you know, just do it and you'll start to get a sense and feel of this. At first it's imagination, so when we're breathing in, you know, the nostril, we follow the breath, and it's as if it hooks back a channel down through the centre of the body. And there's two channels, so when we're breathing out, we can breathe out through both channels. We're breathing in to those two channels. We'll add the central channel later. But that's what we're going to sort of really be thinking about with this breathing. So it's getting a real chance to get in touch with those two side channels that run through the centre of the body. And it's the same system that we're working with Qi. You know, it's the same. It's the soft, subtle body that we don't notice. Okay, so just breathing out. We're going to start with a count. I'll just talk you through it, sorry. We'll start with an inhalation of four and just break for two, and then exhale for six. Take a pause for three, I'll talk you through it, and then breathing in four again, and we'll do three of each round, and we build up and then come back down to the four. So we'll be building up to eight, breathing into eight and coming back down. Okay, so just relax your breathing. Take focus to the nose, tip of the nostril. Just watch the breath going in and out gently. That just settles the mind onto the breathing. And then when you're ready, start to breathe into a count of four. Breathing into the tummy, opening out. But this time, thinking about those two channels, try and connect to those two channels. Three, four, and then hold for a count of two at the top of the breath. And then breathe out for a count of six. So this really is when we start to control the breath. Breathing out and just lengthening that exhalation to a count of six. And hold for three. And then breathe in again to a count of four. Hold, two. And breathe out to a count of six. Hold for three. Breathe in to a count of four. Really trying to connect to those lovely fine channels in the centre of the body, down towards the tummy. Holding for a count of two, and breathing out to a count of six. Stay with the breath, mind stays on the breath. And hold for a count of three. So now we're going to breathe into a count of six. Hold for a count of three. Stay in the channels if you can. And breathe out to a count of eight. Hold for a count of four. Breathe in to a count of six. Hold for a count of three. And breathe out to a count of eight. Hold for a count of four. breathe in to a count of six. Breathe out to a count of eight. And hold for a count of four. And then if you just relax a moment there. We can then increase the count to eight. Breathing in to eight, holding for four, and breathing out to ten, holding for five. But we'll go back down the count now. So going back down to four, exhaling for six. With a break of two and three. So it's all in that little file that is on the website, so you don't need to worry about remembering it. So now breathing in again to a count of four. Hold for a count of two. And breathe out to a count of six. With a breath, stay in the channels if you can, just imagine. Hold for a count of three. Breathe in to a count of four. Hold to a count of two. And breathe out to a count of six. Hold for a count of three, feel that pause. Stay in the channels. And then breathe in to a count of four again. Hold for a count of two. And breathe out to a count of six. Hold for a count of three, and then just relax the breathing. So that's a really good way to exercise the breathing, the lungs, but it's also just a fantastic way to begin to get a sense of this subtle body that we all have, and get into contact with that, and it becomes very useful in meditation practice. So the next one we're going to do is the alternate nostril breathing. A really good breathing exercise when you're in tension, when you're in stress, when you're preparing for an exam or anything like this, you know. But also as a preparation before you do your meditation. And so we'll begin by closing one nostril, the right nostril, and we can just do it with the fingers. It's simple. I mean, you may find that more comfortable later, but just using the fingers and also so you can see what I'm doing. Close the right nostril. I'll talk you through this. You need to do this for at least 3 or 4 minutes to get the effect, the tranquilizing effect, okay? So breathing out through the left nostril. And then breathe in gently, filling the tummy. Just to your capacity. Now close the left nostril and breathe out through the right. Trying to take a pause at the top and the bottom of the breath. And then breathe out through that same nostril. And breathe in again. Now close the right nostril and breathe out through the left. A little pause. Breathe in through the left. Close the left nostril, breathe out through the right. breathe in through the right. Close the right and breathe out through the left. Breathe in through the left. Opening up the body, pause at the top of the breath, and breathe out through the right. Close the right and breathe out through the left. Now just try and keep that going for a couple more minutes. So you're always breathing in and out through one nostril and then changing to the opposite one. Breathing out. Taking a breath in. And then closing that nostril and doing the same on the opposite side, breathing out. Then a breath in. Before you alternate to the opposite nostril, breathing out. Breathing in. And then onto the opposite side. So it's always a breath out, a breath in, and then changing the nostril to breathe out. And you find you can control the breathing quite nicely through one nostril. You know, remembering those three parts of the breath. No straining always, as we all say, but you really can get a nice full breath with a lot of control. And then on the next outward breath. Just relax. Very interesting, this breath is, apart from being great preparation for meditation, great if you've got a stressful situation to face. It's really good if you've got hiccups, because it alters the spasm in the diaphragm and it relaxes it. So if you can take just a couple of minutes, it's better than standing on your head and trying to drink water or whatever. Okay, so if you've got time to do those things before you do your sitting practice, it makes a big difference. And if you can just pick one of those things, breathing exercises, if you haven't got much time, then it will make a difference. So we're going to finish off now with the 9-round breathing. Again, we're going to think about those channels and we're going to add the central channel. Now in this breathing we work just down to here, just below, four fingers below the tummy button, but in fact the channels run right the way top to bottom to the pockets. But this is the part of them that we're concentrating on, and the two channels are going in through the nostrils, hooking back like an umbrella handle down through the center of the body, just in front of the spine, the very fine tubes, channels, And in the centre, because they're right next to a central channel, which is even finer. So when we breathe in, we're going to concentrate on these channels, and on our final breath, we're going to use that central channel. And also this time, we're going to add a thought. So when we're breathing in, just as usual, breathing in all that lovely prana, that lovely energy, thinking about the channels and just going into the subtle body. If we can't actually feel it, just imagine it. It's an idea. We gradually will. As we breathe out, we're going to expel things that we don't want. And in this case, we're going to exhale attachment. And we're going to exhale anger. And then ignorance, not knowing. So I'll talk you through it. This is all again in the information on the website as well. So we first close the right nostril and just breathe out gently through the left. Now breathe in through the left nostril, thinking about those channels, focusing on the breath and following it down towards the tummy button and below. Now that breath crosses over to the right channel, and as you breathe out all your attachment. Really collect it in the channel, collect it on the breath, and breathe out all the attachment into space. Close the right nostril again. Now breathe in through the left nostril. Following that breath down towards the tummy button, it crosses over to the opposite channel, and you breathe out all the attachment. Gather it onto the breath. Breathe it out through the right nostril. Into space, it dissolves. And one more time, close the right nostril. Breathe in through the left. The tummy button, it crosses over into the right channel and gather the attachment and breathe it away. Into space, it dissolves and becomes harmless. Relax. So now we're going to close the left nostril and breathe in through the right, and when we breathe out through the left nostril, we're going to breathe out all the anger. Just gather whatever anger you have, you'll have it somewhere, sometimes stronger than others, but just gather that feeling of anger, and it doesn't have to be against anything, it's just that feeling, and just breathing it out into space. It dissolves, it dissipates, it becomes completely harmless. Okay. So, closing the left nostril, breathe in through the right nostril, just focusing on the breath and following it into those channels or the idea of that. Down towards the tummy button, and as you move your finger over to the right nostril, it crosses into the left nostril, and you breathe out all that anger. Gather it onto the breath. Breathe it away. And then close the left nostril again. Breathe in through the right nostril. Lovely prana, lovely energy, lovely chi. Down to the tummy, it crosses over. Breathe out through the left nostril, gathering all that anger onto the breath, and breathe it out through the left nostril, and away. It dissolves. And one more time, close the left nostril, breathe in through the right. All that lovely prana. Close the right nostril, and breathe out through the left channel. All that anger gathers onto the breath, breathe it all. all away. Into space. It dissolves and becomes harmless. Fabulous. So, the next breath is through both nostrils, so we're going to follow the breath down through the two pine side channels. When it comes down just below the tummy, we're going to tuck it into the central channel and breathe it all up through the central channel and out through the crown. And this is our ignorance, or our not knowing, or our not understanding. So if you can somehow get a feel of that, and gather it and breathe it out and away. Okay, so just breathing out as normal, and then breathing in gently through both nostrils. All the lovely prana, nice three-part breath, down towards the tummy. Now tuck the prana, the exhalation, into the central channel and breathe away all that ignorance. Right up through the crown and out into space above you, where it dissolves. Breathing in again. Staying with the breath. Just trying to travel into the centre of the body, down those two channels. The breath tucks into the central channel, imagine it. And then breathing out all that ignorance, not knowing, not understanding. And breathe it out through the crown of your head, into space. It dissolves. And one last time, breathing in. Lovely prana, fill that body. Stay in the channels if you can. Down towards the tummy, just below. Tuck the breath into the central channel. Try to get a feel of it. And breathing out all our ignorance, our misunderstanding. Up through the crown of the head, into space. It dissolves and becomes harmless. So those are the basic practices of pranayama. Once we get a hold of these basic techniques, then we can go on to much stronger stuff. But I'm not going to teach that until we have got some practice of the pranayama going, because it can be very dangerous. Just, you know, it's very strong stuff on the body, so we don't want to be going on to things like bastrika breathing or the arm breathing. You've heard about all these things. You need this strong basis first, and just with this alone you've got a fantastic practice for keeping well and for preparing you to sit on your mat for your meditation. It just makes all the difference. So I hope that's useful to you. I hope I'll see you possibly in the future at one of our classes at Land of Joy. And thank you so much for joining me. And any effort you put into this will be great for you. It will be great for everybody around you.